Well, 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 welcome back to Krown's Crypto Cave. No longer in the witness protection program, now just an angry tomato talking about magic and money. And as always, want to wish you well and the start to your week and a nice little Saturday over here from Helsinki, Finland. As you can see in the background, nice and overcast once again. It's just the rate of the day, as they say. That's just Finland for you. Anyways, with all that said, I do want to wish you well. We got plenty to talk about with Bitcoin taking a massive leap up during the overnight session, hitting our second target that we spoke about from really early this week, but following up just each and every day, which I want to spend a little bit of time just talking about because these things, they take their time, right? And this has been a great example of just showing how patience within the overall greater sphere of things, can be quite profitable. Again, it takes a little bit of patience, but targets certainly hit over time. Just, you know, it takes its time to formulate. Anyways, I'm just talking to myself right now. Let me get into the good old live scene. So let's initiate that good old teleportation and I'll see you in the live scene. There it is, Bitcoin and all of our glory, closing a very, very powerful daily, but not just a daily. We also closed a three-day deal yesterday night, which to me is looking pretty damn good. I'd say any sort of a retest back down to the red 10 simple around 8,300. And I do like from this perspective, we are going to be seeing also on the three-day, the yellow 20-month exponential moving average crossing back up to the upside of this white 200 simple, the first cross that we've seen in quite some time. Let's actually go on over here to our Bitstamp chart. You do see that when it crosses the downside right over here, pretty damn bad. Obviously, that was the last of the rally attempts for 2018 before Bitcoin was sent down from 6,500 down to 3,100. And of course, the last time that we got, cross the upside on these guys as well was all the way over here on December 9th of 2015 when Bitcoin was around $400. So again, we're just seeing another, overall bullish thing that does set the tone for the more long-term look on this. Of course, though, does that mean that Bitcoin can have very nasty pullbacks? Yes, of course it's going to have its nasty pullbacks. That's just how Bitcoin operates. I do think that Bitcoin will have these 30 to 40% pullbacks that we've seen in the past. Again, but right now, I mean, what is this telling me when I see these sorts of structural things being set down? Well, it tells me that I'd like to be a buyer of those pullbacks. And again, just another thing kind of populating the charts. We do have obviously the golden cross on the 3-day. We have golden crosses on all time frames, essentially below a 3-day, or I suppose below a 4-day maybe. And when I look at this, this is overall good. We do have a very strong area right around 7,200, which is still an area of consideration. Do not get me wrong. We still do have the gap on the CMEs from, I believe, the 17th of May coming in down around here. That will come into play at some point in time. But right here, right now, Bitcoin obviously very far and away from this area. And while we are on the lower time frames, let's actually go over here to a fresh chart on GDAX. And you can see that Bitcoin's been very constructive. And this is exactly what we've been talking about over the past, over the past 4 to 5 months, but we identified it again during this past month, that Bitcoin is just getting, is just having another one of these reaccumulation phases where we have these very violent down moves. Like we saw that swing from 9,100 down to about 8,400, but it never gets any fall through after that. The fall through is stifled and we get reaccumulated typically on some sort of like major moving average. In this case, it was the 4-hour purple 200 exponential moving average right over here. And after that, just floats onwards and upwards. We've seen it a million times throughout these past 4 to 5 months since switch round. Very violent move down right over here. No fall through after that, and then just floats on up. Same thing right over here in middle of May. And same thing right over here. Same thing, right over here. You get the idea. And with this sort of thing, this is just the overall power of the market speaking volumes right now. So I will chart this one out a little bit more. We do have a very obvious horizontal right over here. And what are we kind of making? We're making an ascending triangle right now is what we're making. Volume signature does confirm this. We do have a nice orderly drop off in volume and it's actually getting quite mature, which would suggest that we are going to be ready to break relatively soon. If you're not familiar with an ascending triangle, ascending triangles are typically statistically more likely to break out to the upside than the downside. Of course, I always say I never trust any of those sorts of things with cryptocurrencies. I've seen every pattern break out every goddamn which way. What I can say with strong certainty though is that I'm a believer in supporting resistance. And so if we do break above this trend line right over here at about 88, let's call it like 88, let's call it about 8,800, close like a 12-hour dildo above there. I wouldn't want to see a higher time frame closed above there. Then yes, we will have a measure move actually deep into the 9,000s. Let's see what this one kind of suggests. But I would imagine probably somewhere around like 9,600 if I had to guess. Let's see, just eyeballing it up. And no, sorry, I'm way off on that 10,000. Holy shit, so there's your 10,000. There's your 10,000 tick. And that does line up with our past prior high right over here in May 2018. A little bit above there. But overall, this is building up a very strong case right now, and balked at to fucking not consider this. This is very important right now. So again, I'm not the biggest formation trader myself. Of course, you probably know that if you have been tuned into this content. But I do like triangles, and ascending triangles, descending triangles, symmetrical triangles all seem to have some good merit in cryptocurrency. If I were gonna play a pattern, channels as well are okay. And then after that, then it starts to get to like not so interested in these. But overall, yes, we do now have a full-on formation in the making. And according to volume signature, we are getting, like I said, quite mature within this area. I would be looking for a formal attempt to actually break this probably within the next week. And we're really seeing Bitcoin kind of pull through and do what BNB and Litecoin did now. Going over here to the weekly, we do see that this weekly has essentially just been bought up the whole blood of last week. So no fall through to the downside, and then Bitcoin just floats up once again. This was my biggest gripe with how Bitcoin was looking. Coming into this week, all lower time frames below a weekly were looking like they wanted some upside. We were bullish on those, but I did say that, you know, weekly was the one. If I had to be bearish on anything, it would be the weekly, putting in a doji diddle right over here plus follow through, and then we had weekly stows cross on the downside. But all of this is going to be superseded if we even just tick above the high of last week's dildo, which was 87.42 spot 48. We actually got up to 87.38 spot 92, so just a few bucks off the actual high. So I would be looking for Bitcoin to give a formal attempt. I'm just curious how the other exchanges look. Bitstamp was about $8 under as well. BitMexico was about $1.50 below. So yeah, there you go. Bitcoin really fighting for it right here. And the second that we take out the high of last week's dildo at 87.42, I would be looking for some more continuation here. And that's going to likely lead on to resolution of that ascending triangle that we looked at. And then we have a legitimate target around 10,000. Now, I would say this. I wouldn't, while technically the target would be 10,000, I would have a very cautious eye on 9,600. 9,600, a very, very, a very strong area. We do see that's kind of like the past prior weekly high, the swing high from right over here. Again, in April of 2018. So I'd be kind of making this as like a boxy territory. It's quite large at, you know, about from 9,600 to 10,000, essentially, you know, $400, which now is actually not, now it's like a 4% move. We're talking about a weekly here, so the margin of error does get boosted up a bit. And my point is that anywhere between that area is where I'm going to start to look for. I'm looking for shorts is, you know, do I really want to be looking for shorts? I mean, I want to be taking profit off of longs is what I want to be doing. And of course, full disclosure, I want to follow up on my positions yesterday. Hey, refresh, you fuck. Come on, Deribit, you're doing yourselves no justice right now. You're a great exchange, and then you do all the, and then you do all this bullshit. I only sold 5 of these 8,000 strike puts. Actually, to get a lot more on my main account, I figured I'd follow up on that. Turn in a few bucks right over there. Crazy numbers. Really would have liked to have sold like 10 times this amount. I wanted to talk about how I was going to cover that if it did go against me, because if Bitcoin headed back down below 8,100, I'd be happy to cover that. Still get to keep the profit of them and actually, you know, collect on the difference between the spot underline and in the strike. Looking back on perps right over here, the spot underline positions, still holding the same positions, essentially. Still a little bit long. I haven't really been focusing too much on my trading activities on my streamer account, just because I've been dealing with some life stuff right now, preparing perhaps big things. Anyways, so with all that said, you know, weeklies quickly switched around right there, which was exactly the right bias to have, because all of the lower time frames were telling us that we had some more upside. And in fact, looking at the daily right here, I mean, we actually have a full-on bullish posture now. We do have the purple 200 exponential moving average fully confirmed above that blue 3-7-cent exponential moving average. So all lower periods are trading above higher. We did just get the red 10 symbol cross the upside of the yellow 21. So we literally have every last lower period trading above a higher. We got the 10 above the 21, above the 50, above the 89, above the 200, above the 3-7-7. And with that paired up with this being an ascending triangle and Bitcoin having plenty of room on the daily Stokes and Bitcoin regaining the exponential on the RSI, which, by the way, has actually broken out of this downward trend channel right over here, which is now confirmed as well. Some like this. Well, I guess it wasn't on this time frame. I believe it was on the 8-hour that I was looking at it on. Yeah, right over here. I would say that this is a pretty damn good sign. Now the measure, I suppose you can't really make a measure move on, you know, on a break of a falling channel on the RSI, but typically you want to see it get back to the prior highs is like the obvious trade. Well, we pretty much done that so far, but just looking at structure right here, this is just reaccumulation. It essentially just looks like we're kind of creating a cup and handle in the formation. Now we don't have the handle just yet, but I would imagine that we have a nice cup of base coming in right around this area right over here, this dotted trend line, which if I do pull things out, you will notice that this dotted trend line goes all the way back from the genesis of Bitcoin. And whenever Bitcoin's below it, very bad. That's kind of like during its accumulation phases. And whenever Bitcoin's above it, you know, well, actually, sorry, that's not the right way to interpret it. When we were below it over here, yes, this was accumulation, but when we broke above it, parabolic times. And then after that, you know, Bitcoin blows off its top, comes back down and bases upon it, and then rallies back up for another parabolic attempt. And then we pop back down below it again. And just like we saw way back on over here, almost eight or so years, that was a good accumulation area, which Bitcoin has broken back above this area once again. So my initial thoughts when I was first constructing this was that when Bitcoin breaks below it, it'll never break back above it, actually. But no, I think I'm obviously wrong on that, but the right way to be interpreting this is what it looks like is that anything below this dotted trend line is actually a really good accumulation level. And I didn't have the foresight to see that. So again, you know, I thought that was like a huge death sentence a couple months ago when 6 months ago, 7 months ago when Bitcoin broke it over here. No, not at all. In fact, it's just kind of telling us about the overall phase of the market cycle. Now that we've pumped back above it once again, we do see that it's actually quite the strong base. I mean, this is your 3-day dildo time frame right over here, which is also supported by the way, by the white 200 simple. And we do see Bitcoin, you know, basing off of it once, basing off it twice, three times, four times, and then up. And that is a damn good signal that this is a very, very strong integral area of Bitcoin. And if we do have a major down, I'd be looking for a major bounce off that area. That's a pretty damn important area going forwards now. So again, I do like what I see from a longer term perspective. It doesn't mean that we can't have 30 to 40% retracements, and I'm sure that we will, but those are going to be major buys most likely until Bitcoin puts in its next major top, essentially. But yeah, looking at the 3-day right over here, damn good close last night. Of course, we still do have a little bit of issues with 3-day Stokes, but they literally just crossed back up to the upside. I mean, this is so fucking strong. We haven't seen this too often in Bitcoin's history. A couple times over here in 2016. But other than that, very rarely do you see a signature like this on your 3-day Stokes, which have been pretty damn good. But pairing this up with price action and also the Jewel, which actually the Jewel, we spoke about this as well, coming down into support. This is a support area right here with the white, as I'm showing it. It might be yellow if you have access to it for yourself. But yes, you know, when I look at that, it's actually suggesting that we probably tick back up. Also pairing that up with the 3-day RSI. I mean, the 3-day RSI is just consolidation is what it's telling us. It's just consolidation in the bullish control zone, which is a good thing. I mean, that's a good thing. So again, looking at all of these things, they've just completely switched around. Now obviously all of the time frames below this were looking good the whole way through, but those were my main concerns with Bitcoin. Although, you know, of course the bias to the upside in the short and medium and I suppose long term as well, you know, still holds true based off that. Looking at 2-day Stokes going to be hinting at across the upside. We will get that confirmed later tonight at 8 p.m. Eastern time. Any close here or higher will be good enough for that. And again, you know, this also was just allowed to reset after coming down from the more critical zone into the edge of the bullish control zone, while Bitcoin had very little damage to price action, just getting reaccumulated right here. Again, it's, you know, powerful shit. Looking at 2-day RSI, do we have anything here? Again, just, you know, oscillating between the bullish control zone and the neutral zone. Again, essentially a bullish a bullish, what's it called, a bullish consolidation. Not only that, but you know, depending upon how you kind of judge this, you could make the argument that this is a hidden bullish divergence between this point and this point. I don't know if I'd really count that. But my point is that we have a lot of technicals lining up with this as well. Looking at the daily, again, daily had a damn good close. We already looked at daily stocks, plenty of room to roll over here, and these have been damn good at getting the overall movements. Not only that, but if you do have access to the jewel, I do not look at this as a sell signal right here. Probably not a sell signal, unless we like really fucking curve down from that pink and really reject from it, which I'm not really leaning towards it happening. I do think that we shoot up above it. And again, you know, if you have access to the jewel, this is a good example, just because I really don't like it when the light blue is super has a very aggressive slope coming into one of the resistances or supports. When it has a very aggressive slope, that means we're having a moving train right now. And also paired up with the fact that our long-term trend identifier in the background over here, the auto fib, is showing some green. Everything's kind of lining up right now, so I would give more weight to that. Of course, we do have like we said before, daily RSI breaking the downwards channel and getting and regaining the exponential, which to me very, very powerful in the overall context of the structure. So everything looks good to me here. It probably takes its time, but I would say that as long as Bitcoin remains above, oh motherfucker, my price area just went away. Let me see if I go to like something like this. Yeah, there we go. As long as Bitcoin maintains its level above about 8350, 8300, I would be with a medium to long term bullish bias, saying that this is going to break to the upside, and we do have legitimate targets technically to 10,000. I do think 9600 is an area of consideration, though. Everyone's going to be talking about 10,000. It's going to be a big psychological number as well, and it's one of those things where if everyone's talking about it, we either get front ran or we bulldoze past it and liquidate all of the geniuses, you know, talking about the same thing, trying to be heroes, shorting that, or prematurely shorting that area. Again, that's why I don't like shorting. That's why I don't like shorting that kind of shit. What I like to do is I like to, you know, be closing longs. Just like in the bear market, I wanted to be closing shorts. Now I want to be closing longs. And man, it's gonna be very bizarre for the newer people to this community, which I do want to welcome in. But it probably just sounds like I'm a permabull or some shit, which I have been, because we've been in a bull run. During all of 2018, I'd be called like a perma bear because this fucking bear trend. And the only thing that I was really interested in doing was shorting. Well, now the only thing that I'm really interested in doing is buying. Is it going to be profitable to short the next top? Yeah, absolutely. You're probably looking at a pullback of at least 20%, probably 30 to 40%. So it's going to be very fucking profitable, but I'd rather just make life easy for myself and trade with the macro trend, of which we do have the macro trend, you know, just strengthening over time. We do have the monthly, which has created its first higher high in the span, you know, over the course of like a year and a half, getting above this pump right over here. We do not necessarily have a higher low just yet, but just put this in perspective and why I'm really not looking for Bitcoin to have like a major down from this area anytime soon. Not anytime soon, but just hear me out. is essentially because on the monthly, we do want to see a higher low at some point in time to confirm, you know, a straight up, you know, an upwards market. Right now we have a higher high. We don't necessarily have a higher low. We need both to create an uptrend essentially. And to put this in perspective, if we were going to come back down and put in a higher low, we'd first have to put in some sort of reversal dildo right here. Then we'd have to get follow through to the downside, and then we'd have to set in a higher low. So it'd be at minimum like 3 months before that even happened. And to me, this looks a lot more like continuation rather than anything. In fact, looking at our monthly oscillators, look at your monthly stokes, straight up and very powerfully erect, like painfully erect, just like we saw it, during the end of 2015 right over here, which did actually get a pretty nasty pullback. But after that, the bullish momentum began. Not only that, but we do see monthly RSI regaining the exponential right over here, just like you saw in 2015 as well, which did accurately get the bullish momentum lining up with this area right over here. And then the retest of that exponential being another great buy point right here in about January before the next sort of just major pumpage, I suppose you could say. Major pumpage, major boobage, if you know what I'm talking about. Well, what was that song in that one? That was a good song. It's really good. It always gets stuck in your head too. Anyways, so yeah, you know, looking at some, you know, looking at this, it does kind of put in perspective the sort of timing of this. And I do believe that the next higher low probably does go somewhere wherever the yellow 20 minute exponential is on the monthly, probably does come back down to test it. And that's going to likely be, you know, the next major buy. Keep in mind, it is rising rather aggressively. Last month it was 5,500. Now it is 5,800. So about $300 each and every monthly tick, which we'll be getting another one in a couple of weeks. And so that'd bring us up, you know, above 6,000, which would put us at that 2018 support level. Anyways, you know, that's obviously, again, you know, a consideration. I just don't think is probably happening right now, but just to put it in perspective with all that, I do think it's important. Anyways, okay, so let's go back down to, we haven't really talked about the lower time, like the super crack trader timeframes. Here's hourly. Hourly is just flagging out. I always get a little bit apprehensive when I look at something like this, but technically, yes, just a bullish continuation pattern right over here. There is a measured move to be made off something like this, off a little bit of a bull flag, and we can do that right here, right now. And technically, it's going to, you know, it's probably going to be showing us that, probably going to be showing that we do break this resistance that we were speaking about earlier right over here. Let me just kind of zoom in on this. There we go. It would suggest that we actually break this next level of resistance right around the 8850-ish region. So if we can close the next, you know, an hourly wouldn't do it for me, but like a 12-hour would do it for me. I really want to be conservative with this one, but if we do see it, you know, a higher time frame, maybe even a 4-hour if you're a little bit more aggressive, closing above 8850 and fulfilling that move, then that's where I start to look for the next major move, again, into like 9,600 target to 10,000-ish region. So that is becoming a legitimate topic of conversation. We now have the formation in place, and there you go. So that was hourly. Let me actually do a little bit more of a dissection here. I don't really trust it all that much right now because we do see hourly stokes kind of coming down, and I really just don't like trading on weekends to begin with. It does seem quite likely to me that we come back down and retest this blue box territory. I'd like to see what the reaction is if and when that does happen. Hourly jewel did give a sell signal right over here, so I don't like to go against that. Although it's not a perfect sell signal, it's pretty damn good. But not perfect. What about and again, this is an hourly. Like, do I trust an hourly signal over what the higher time frames are telling me? Fuck no. But you might have like $100, $200 move. What do we got on 2-hour? 2-hour RSI getting up there a little bit. Still constructive, but is going to be building some bearish divergence relatively soon. 2-hour Stokes getting way, way done up there as well. But again, you know, probably doesn't stay up there for too much longer. So lower time frames very easily could have a little bit of a pullback here. So if I did have to judge it, I would say lower time frames probably pull back. Maybe 8,600 to 8,500-ish region would be where I'm looking towards. Higher time frames still looking bullish to me. 4-hour, we haven't looked at the 4-hour either. 4-hour just looks like consolidation. 4-hour looks good. 4-hour Stokes way up there. Again, way up there. That is a little bit scary. No doubt about that. 4-hour RSI getting up. You know, it's too high, bro. Bro, that RSI way too high. We're going down right now. Get your shorts in and get ready to wreck those dumb bulls. Well, dumb bulls are going to be making a lot more money than smart bears, unfortunately, during a bull market. So yeah, again, the worst thing that you can do is be rational in an irrational market, and Bitcoin is a definition of fucking irrational. Technical term as well. Anyways, 4-hour RSI will be building some divergence most likely, but not there just yet. Not there just yet. In fact, 4-hour jewel working its way up into this region. Again, it's not quite there just yet, but it's getting a little bit more scary. I don't know how much more on the lower timeframes that we have as far as gas for this run goes, but that's not a Neo reference, but I do, you know, I do think higher time frames still look good to me. We can look at the 6-hour for a second as well. 6-hour closed very well. I do like that one. 6-hour Stokes up there as well. Not so different than the 4 hours. 6-hour RSI, again, you know, getting to that next level. I do think that it tries to construct a little bit after a pullback, though. I do think that we're going to try to flag out this area and basically create a cup and handle, which cup and handle will have its own measure move as well, something like this. And again, just eyeballing it, this is very premature. This is not good technical analysis. What I'm doing, I'm just doing something for demonstration purposes and just for my own knowledge. And yeah, that'd be pointing actually towards that 10,000 target. Holy shit, we got multiple things pointing towards 10,000. There you go. Cup and handle isn't in just yet, though. We don't have the right side handle, so I'm breaking like the first rule of pattern trading to begin with. You're supposed to wait for the actual pattern to be in there, and I would say that that's the best way of doing it. Anyways, let's go check out CME's. They closed 84.75 over the weekend. And for CME's, this is a pretty damn good close on the daily, actually. And I do think that, you know, this will be consideration going forwards as Bitcoin obviously trading above it right now. But of course, I wouldn't really be using this until we see CME's open back up on Sunday at 7 p.m. Eastern time. If they do open back up while spot is trading above, then I'd probably be a buyer anywhere around 8,500. If spot is trading below, it might be a good scalp short. But I would be careful with that. But of course, we still have a lot of time to go before that's even a consideration. Let's see how the weekly closed for this one. The weekly closed okay. I'd say that the weekly closed okay. We're still gonna have weekly SOS coming down. We're still gonna have weekly RSI building divergence. We're still gonna have weekly Joule giving off a warning signal. But none of those is really actionable in and of themselves. It's just warning signals all around, which you know probably plays out at a later date. Looking at daily, not too much else to say about this. So the that hasn't been said already on the spot. Looks fine to me. Just looks like a reaccumulation pattern above all major moving averages as well. Hard chart to hate, I suppose. What about GBDC? GBDC closed today up a little bit, sold off a little bit at the close. Not as good as the other ones. This one looking a little bit more head and shoulders-y, but even this is not a head and shoulders. And again, for the people calling head and shoulders, I mean, for fuck's sake, if you're going to be a pattern trader, at least do it right. At least do it right. It ain't the right size. It ain't the right shape. It ain't the right neckline. It ain't the right taste. It ain't the right smell. And it's a fucking head and shoulders in cryptocurrency against the overall macro trend. You might want to check out the statistics on those. It's less than 40%. Anyways, yeah, not looking. This one wouldn't look as good. And in fact, the weekly does look okay, just because the last weekly did have such a long wick to the downside. I do consider this a test of the red 10 simple, and we got a bullish cross of the yellow 21 and the green 55. I would say that I wouldn't say that it looks good, but it looks okay. Maybe we're just trying to consolidate this area right here, which is what it does look like on the lower time frames. And that's what spot charts look like. So I'd give the nod to that. Anyways, go check out the other top shitcoins. I'm curious what the market leaders are doing. Mrs. Litecoin over here. Mrs. Litecoin came down. Did she hit our target? 125.5. Okay, so I think my target on the lower time frames was 125.5. So we did get that hit, but I was saying that we probably do come back down and test the red 10 simple. We didn't get that. That would have been a couple bucks lower, but again, good enough is good enough. And Mrs. Litecoin actually building up another constructive case right here. I like what she's doing. This powerful lady marching her way onwards and forwards. Weekly still looking good to me. 12 hour looking good. I do think that Mrs. Litecoin reaches back towards 139, 140 ish region, and then probably gives another test towards our overall target of 146 to 150 ish range, right around here. If we can actually see that, I do believe that this is the next area of major interest. So I wouldn't be getting too damn greedy in this region. But yeah, Mrs. Litecoin building it back up. Very, very powerful response. And I do think that's we give another legitimate try for that area. What about daily? We haven't really looked at the daily too much here. Yeah, daily stocks crossing back up to the upside. What about 12 hour? Yeah, 12 hour looking a little bit different. Sloppy, but I do think that it gets another attempt. What about Mr. Buterol? I forgot to cover him yesterday. I do apologize about that. Don't want to be leaving him out. Mr. Buterol looking like he wants to follow in Mr. Bitcoin's steps. Probably move back up to 270. I think my target yesterday was right around 265. We already hit that today. I'd say 270, 271, 272. Looking like Bitcoin as well. So I do think that Mr. Buterol falls through. We did have a pretty damn good reaction yesterday, so I would be bullish here. I do think that Mr. Buterol does take another leg up. Looking at daily Stokes, plenty of room. Looking at daily RSI, very constructive, and just regain the exponential. I like what I see here, and I really like the reaction of yesterday's close. This is good structure. Yes, probably around 270, and then we'll talk about, you know, potentially higher targets up to this next resistance from like 278 region. What else do we got? Let's look at BNB. I consider BNB a market leader as well now. How did he react yesterday? Yeah, good buy up to save the daily. Operation Save the Daily initiated by good old CZ. And, you know, as long as this trend line doesn't break right here, it's still okay from a technical analysis perspective. Pretty aggressive downwards move right there, though I would say that it's not the most healthy move. Daily Stokes still have plenty of room, still pointed north. I don't really have any other opinion on BNB other than that. I need to see. I guess I could be cautiously bullish on this as long as it holds the yellow 21 exponential moving average on the daily. The second that it breaks it, though, I would get bearish for a move back down below $30. Right now, you know, looking resilient within this region. But that, you know, that, you know, this selling that we saw yesterday was pretty nasty, although bought back up even better. So you know what? No, I do lean to the upside here for BNB. I do think that it pops back up to $33.50, and then we'll reassess it from there. What about the other top shitcoins? What about Cardano? Cardano holding on to the lows like a fucking trooper. There you go, Cardano. Hold in there, baby. Hold in there. I would refrain from getting too damn bearish on these on these guys. Even though some of the alts are making new lows right now, I do believe that is to do with the news from Binance, right? The news from Binance saying that they're basically gonna have a new exchange for American customers, where you can trade only American approved shitcoins. So the shitcoin roulette kind of getting shuffled off the table. And what we see on Cardano, I believe Cardano is compliant with US, just because they're on Bittrex, I know, and Poloniex, which are both US compliant exchanges. And I would say this for Cardano, I'd still be willing to call this likely the low, as long as we do not violate 10, even just 1,000, even if you want to make it easy. If 1,000 gets violated, then yes, probably does make some new lows. But as long as it holds up above 1,000, I do think that this is actually still okay. We do see the daily actually having a decent reaction yesterday, although I'm not a big fan of this setup right here. It's not a good setup. If I was going off the daily, I would be bearish. Daily soaks coming down, daily losing the 21. This is likely to probably come down a little bit more, but again, I'd be going off the weekly for all these guys just in case, just to be like extra cautious. It spent the last five, six weeks consolidating this area. I'd give it a little bit more of a leash. So yeah, I'd still be willing to call it for some like Cardano. Most things, a lot of shitcoins in this market, especially the Binance shitcoin relay table. Well, not so much. They're making new lows and they're telling you right now which ones are not going to be the winners. Zcash, what's Zcash doing? Pretty good move over here. I'd still say that we probably pop back up to 105.5. Again, taking its time. Daily looks very constructive, just flagging out, and we can make a measure move on this baby. And I do believe that it's something like this. Apply that to the upside. Again, very, very bad way of doing this. And yes, exactly. 105, actually 106. And I really do like that setup. So yeah, Zcash probably does move up here. What about Bcash? Bcash, think the same thing. Hit our first target at 420. Nicely done, Bcash. Probably does make its way towards 430 and 440. I'd be bullish on this one too. Daily Stokes, plenty of room. Daylight right there. Daily RSI looking fine to me as well. Tron, what's Tron Cash doing? Tron Cash fighting for its life as well, but I do think that it pulls through. I do think that short-term target probably somewhere right around here, right around 0.0335. Longer term probably falls the rest of the market and comes back up here. Again, I've been saying this for a while. I do believe that Tron is bottomed. As long as we hang out above 2.09 cents, that is your critical area. That is your structural base, and this is a bottoming formation. As long as this holds true, the second that it breaks, so then not so much. But for now, good. Neo, what's Neo doing? Having a good reaction as well, actually falling through a little bit more than most of the market. And what we are finding resistance on the, you know, on the retest of the prior on the prior high. I do think that this one pulls through overall. We do see daily stocks with again plenty of room in this region. So probably a short-term pullback. If I had to go with the lower time frames, yep, short-term pullback, maybe back down to like 13, 15 or something like that. And then I give another try to the upside. What's EOS doing? EOS, 4-hour looking constructive. 4-hour just regained the 200 simple. I do think that EOS is actually getting ready for a move right here towards seven and a quarter. Daily looking good as well. Yeah, EOS wants to move up 7.25 and probably beyond over time. Looking good. Daily Stokes just fresh. This is probably the most actionable one right now, actually. Okay, XRP, what do we got on XRP? Again, same sort of thing as we said yesterday. Short-term target, probably still 42 cents is what I'd be sticking towards. Probably works its way back up towards 43 anyways. You know, it's in this nice formation right here. Above all major moving averages, has the golden cross with the green and the purple. I do believe that this one ultimately pulls through to the upside, but again, taking its time. What about Monero? Monero Cash, looking pretty good as well. One of the more stronger ones in this market, I would say. Probably does reach for this next target right around 90, let's just call it $98. Again, another ascending triangle in this region right over here. If it breaks above $98, we're probably gonna be talking, I think 120 would be next target over time. Stellar, what's Stellar doing? Same thing as Ripple, kind of. I think short-term target about 13 cents. Longer term, probably more around 13 and a half cents, somewhere in this region, kind of just creating its own flag. And the mesh move on the flag does point towards, I believe, 19 cents, if I remember, 18 cents. Okay, close enough. Kind of the lows of 2018 as well over here. Nice one. SPYs, how did traditional markets close this past week? Closed on a fucking green, huh? Nice doji dildo green. I don't like the weekly, though. I do think that the weekly does signal that we probably come back down and test towards 286, 284 region. But I don't feel like I have a good hold on traditional markets right now. I the monthly is going to either turn into incredibly fucking bullish or moderately bearish. Wow, that really changed around the tides real fast. I don't have a strong opinion here, and I don't feel like I have a good hold on this one right now, so I'll kind of refrain from talking about it. I do think that based off the weekly, probably still does come down to 286, 284 region sometime next week. Anyways, back on a Bitcoin, what we got on Mr. Bitcoin, 86.83 and a half on BitMexico, and I think that we can wrap it up quite easily with just the daily. In fact, let's go back to this chart right over here. It's quite literally this simple, and I do believe that this is the right way to be looking at this right now. We do have an ascending triangle, and it does look all right. Volume signature works out, shape works out, size, smell, taste, structure, all good, all looking good to me. Doesn't mean that we can't have another pullback down to like 84 or 8500. I think that would be a good bouncy area, also in confluent with our CME closure on Friday. So, you know, perhaps consideration tomorrow on Sunday when they open back up. But for now, I do think that this is an overall good setup, and any sort of a higher time frame closure above 88.50, and I'd be looking for that next move deep into the 9,000s. Go balls deep for Bitcoin right now, looking good. Actually quite constructive and quite impressive run. All of our targets have been hit within this region right now, so I would say that I'd wait for this next area to get taken out, and then I'd probably add to my longs. Of course, it's not financial advice. I'm not a financial advisor. Just a blanket statement that apparently saves you from everything, all litigations. God, it's probably so misleading. I think I'll leave you off with that. I do want to wish you well. I do want to wish you the best, the happiest, as we say. And take care. I'll see you soon.